nice view. Yeah, it's
blue.
Good to see you.
Hello, and welcome to the opening concert of the Uncertainty of Fate Festival. I'm Rita Porfiris, Chair of Chamber Music and Artistic Director of the festival. This was supposed to be the year we celebrated the 100th anniversary of the Hart School, but then 2020 happened, and we had to get even more creative. This festival of composition and chamber music and dance was conceived as a way to celebrate creativity in the face of adversity. What would composers, choreographers, and musicians do when given the prompt to create short works about their experiences during the 2020 pandemic? In the end, we are presenting 58 works by 51 composers and 4 choreographers, performed by Hart students, faculty, and guests over the next 5 nights. We also had healthcare workers from the VA New England Hospital System write pieces based on their experiences over this year. Some of these works are integrated into the music, and some are simply woven in between the pieces. And you may want to keep a Kleenex box handy for those. We hope you will be able to attend one or both of the panels tomorrow, one tomorrow at 12 and one Tuesday at 9 a.m., with themes of healing in the arts and activating and agitating systemic change in your institution, with a stellar lineup of panelists. All the festival information is available in a 52-page program book PDF online at the Hart live stream page. There you can see composer, writer, choreographer, and performer bios and program notes, all the programs for every concert, and access links to everything as well. If you're joining us on the stream, there is a live chat going on the YouTube stream, and that link is listed also by every concert on the program. Finally, I want to thank especially Dean Larry Allen Smith, as well as Ken Steen, for supporting the vision of the festival and for making Hart a better place to be. Our first piece, the Centennial Suite, is a collection of short movements by 5 composers that was commissioned by the Hart Saxophone Studio in honor of the 100th anniversary of the school. It has been wonderful to see all the creativity in the face of adversity that has come about over the course of creating this festival. And now we celebrate hope for the future as we look to the uncertainty of fate. Thank you.
It's in two short movements. The first is Nothing Much Happens, and the second is entitled Time Flies.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. My name is John Mann, composer of this next piece, which is coming up momentarily.
The title is Body Breaks, Spirit Descends. And I'm so pleased to be able to hear it live. Basically, it's a progressive deconstruction of the Luther chorale, 500 years old, Christ lag in Todesbanden. And it happens in basically three episodes. And as the piece progresses, they become gradually more aleatoric and uncertain, as it were. So excited for the quartet to perform it, and Felicia also, our dancer. Thanks so much.
I read the program notes from the composer. Agita is a representation of my first few months during the COVID-19 pandemic. The frantic introduction leading into the contained yet ever ominous first theme represents the first few months in quarantine with its unsettled accompaniment. The second theme represents the later half of quarantine when I became a happier person, learning to adapt to life during a global pandemic.
The work is meant to be pure, delicate,
and tender. A careful rendering of emotions felt through an immensely challenging time. Notes from composer Paula af Malmborg-Ward. Broken, bleak, row, and choppy chanterelles is an impression of the year 2020, which for me was 100% off, 100% on, with all cancellations and exhausting restarts, only ending up in another big question mark. All we could do was to, quote, keep it up and give it a big laugh if we were all fortunate enough to stay healthy. The piece is based on a song from my production way back called Bleak Row and Chanterelles. It's a fast Latin funk piece, the lyrics being flirty in a witty way. I totally broke it up due to the subject mentioned above. Thank you. Composer Jill DeLines writes, Last Call was written for the Uncertainty of Fate project, spearheaded by Rita Porfiris, who drew together an array of artists with an invitation to create meaning from our pandemic life reflections. Special thanks to Rita for driving the project. And special thanks, too, to Bernie Lyons, 1932 to 2021. Storyteller, force of nature, and dad.
Hi, my name is Daniel Powers. I wrote this piece coming up. It's called Timelines. The piece is just two short movements that both use the same melodic material in entirely different contexts, which I sort of related to my daydreaming about like how this year could have been completely different and how much better it could have been. So thank you.
from the composer. Transforming. I wrote this work during the period of the great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn. The opening of air elemental era is accompanied by the death of old forms and the formation of new ones. The transition is a change between different patterns. In the first measure, four sets were used based on the names of four players. Then the piece was made using subsets and enlargement, concealed repetition, motivic parallelism, nesting, and self-similarity. The whole development process gradually got rid of the strict layout and kept changing the sound form. But no matter what the sound form is, its archetype is always the first measure.
Composer of the next piece entitled Violet Sun. It gets its name from an optical illusion I experienced during a sunrise over Hartford. If you look at the sun for long enough during sunrise, the yellow receptors in your eyes tire out, so you start to see the inverse color, which is violet. The whole piece is inspired by this combination of the alien and the familiar. Thanks to everybody who made this festival possible, and especially to Professor Robert Black.
Good evening. My name is Christy Eccles, and I am the composer of Inherent Exertion. Writing this piece was a challenge for me, not only because I'm writing it for my double bass teacher of 3 years, but because it forced me to examine how the human condition affects my daily life and the choices I make. Ultimately, it led me to create a work for double bass and spoken text that struggles between a nasty, noisy world and a soft, beautiful melody. No one is perfect, and sometimes we make the right choice, but many times we make the wrong choice. The question is, how do we deal with the good and bad choices, and how does it define who we are? Thank you.
We are scared. We want to help. We want to be stable. Why? Compromise. Scared. Help. Compromise. No trust. Safety. Listen. Go out. Help. Safety. Just compromise.
This piece is titled Faster by RJ Dion. Faster was written for a score call initiated by the Hart School in 2020, meant to be regarding the theme to examine the human condition with all its flaws and beauty. Faster is set on the concept on the creative process and trying to balance with profiting off of one's art. This being a constant issue, but even more emphasized during something as tragic as the COVID-19 pandemic. When one is stuck in depression or loneliness, but trying to be creative at the same time, but not moving at the speed they used to or need to.
Thank you.
program notes from Nicholas Rule. With the Darkest Light is a piece reflecting on the optimism and hope that exists during a time where despair and struggle seem to be in the forefront of day-to-day life. While I utilize the G-flat pentatonic scale as a foundation to allow for more open tones, it also forces dissonances in chordal context. The clarinet ensemble is a perfect medium to use such a technique to not only create richness and darkness in the natural dissonances with the warm tone quality of the varied clarinets, but also allows the open intervals to remain bright and airy. In the end, the piece creates and reflects a balance of dark and light that we are experiencing during these times.
name is Jace Jordan. I'm the composer of this next piece, Fanfare and Dance. The piece is in two sections. It's a fragment of a fanfare in the beginning that are on a rhythmically unstable surface, and then the piece builds into a dance to close it out. I hope you enjoy, and thank you so much to Whiskey Tango Foxtrot for playing this.
This next piece, and the final piece of the program, is the second movement of a larger work called Anecdotal Antidotes by David Sampson. David and I met in 1984 when we were asked to join a newly formed brass ensemble called Solid Brass in New Jersey. We became fast friends, and I first knew him as a trumpet player. He went to Curtis, and really fine trumpet player, and only later on did I find out that he was a composer, because he was writing a piece for the group which had a tuba solo in one of the movements, and he wanted to find out more about the instrument and write for it with the knowledge of writing things that I could play. So fast forward, we became very fast friends. Ultimately, he became my daughter's godfather, and a few months ago asked me, he wanted to write me a piece, and he has written several pieces for me over the years, and I said, well, I've just joined this new group, and he had the same reaction I did initially when Phil Snedeker said that we should form this group, which was, really? So he wrote this piece, and as I said, it's originally in three movements, and we're doing the second movement. And this was a gift from him to me and to this wonderful ensemble that you see in front of you. This is the second movement of Anecdotal Antidotes by David Sampson.
Thank you. Thank you.